Hey guys, welcome back to Shade Review. In today's video, we are reviewing the Mr. Light Mermon. So first off, let's pop these sunglasses on face and talk about the dimensions. They have 45mm lenses and a 22mm bridge. And this is a pair of eyeglasses, actually not the sunglasses. These are the Mermon C, not the Mermon S. So there's going to be a couple of differences here. The S and the C are almost identical, but there is one difference, and that is these C sunglasses, which are actually eyeglasses, are a little bit different because they don't have a titanium that surrounds the inside of the lens like they do on their sunglasses. So even though technically this is a pair of eyeglasses, Garrett Light went ahead and swapped in these yellow lenses, which make them more like a pair of sunglasses. But that being said, I actually do like the look of these glasses, and I actually also own another pair of Mr. Light glasses. I own the Getty S, and I did do a full review of those sunglasses. If you guys want to check that out, you can see the titanium that goes on the inside of the frames. And also in that video, I do review the actual Mr. Light lens quality, which I thought was pretty decent, but they don't come with polarized lenses, so I didn't really like them that much. So I figured with this pair, instead of getting the Mermon S, I'd get the Mermon C and then swap out these really cool lenses and kind of get the look that I wanted. So the biggest thing that I noticed when first handling this pair of sunglasses is the frames are absolutely beautiful. The frames are made out of this beautiful acetate material, and I just think they look really nice and premium and kind of help justify their very steep price tag. These have a very traditional keyhole style bridge here, and they also actually have round lenses. So even though the frames aren't necessarily round, the lenses are. So they have that P3 style lens, and I think that also looks really cool on the sunglasses and just adds a little bit extra to the character of the frames rather than more square or boxy sunglasses like the Getty S, which I also do really like, but these are definitely very interesting with the round lenses. These sunglasses have very premium all metal hinges, and they just feel very premium when opening them up, and when closing them, they just feel very nice and good. And it doesn't end there. These all metal hinges have these absolutely beautiful etchings here on them that Mr. Light definitely didn't have to do, but they wanted to do it to just add that extra element of premiumness and the quality. And if we take a look at the top of the hinges, there are actually MR logos, which of course stand for Mr. Light, and that's really cool that they etched that on there as well. Now taking a look at the top of the frames, we can see these hexagonal metal accents here on the top frames and on the temples. So rather than being your traditional circle metal accents or something boring like that, they decided to go with the hexagon look and style, which is really cool. Also, the temples are very cool on the sunglasses as well, as they have a kind of Mephecto stem system substitute where they bend out just like this, and they're going to bend out and give a custom fit to anyone's face. So even though these sunglasses do have those small 45mm lenses and a 22mm bridge, they're gonna fit on my face absolutely perfectly because these temples bend out and just fit the face very well. These frames, and I believe all Mr. Light frames, are made in Japan, and this particular pair of sunglasses says that here in the inner right iris, it just says made in Japan there. And if we take a look at the inner right temple, they say Mr. Light. And then if we take a look at the inner left temple, they say Mermon C Beechwood, and then 45-22, which stands for our lens size and our bridge width. As far as coverage from sun goes, unfortunately, these aren't going to offer the best coverage because they do have those round lenses, and round lens sunglasses never offer good coverage. So there is going to be a pretty big gap up here to let sunlight in unprotected here on top. Then if we take a look here at the sides, again, there is a very big gap to let sunlight in unprotected, so they are definitely not the most practical pair of sunglasses. So this pair of frames is definitely more about looks than practicality. As far as pricing goes, the frames are going to cost you $575 for the eyeglass frames, and if you want to get the sunglass version, they're going to cost you $665, which is a very steep price to pay for a pair of acetate sunglasses, especially when you can't get them with polarized lenses. But the quality of these frames is definitely top-notch. It's some of the best frame quality that I've ever seen in a pair of sunglasses, and they are made in Japan, and they do have titanium bits, but it's definitely very expensive considering the fact that, again, they are an acetate pair of sunglasses. So overall, I do like this pair of sunglasses. I don't know if it's worth the price of around three different pairs of Ray-Ban sunglasses for only one pair of these, but it is definitely unique, and you're gonna stand out from the crowd, and the build quality is just very, very good. So for the most part, you get what you pay for, and that is a very nice and luxurious pair of eyeglasses or sunglasses. So if you have the money, you might wanna think about picking up a pair and getting to experience these beautiful sunglasses for yourself. But that's all I have for you guys in this video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up down below. And of course, make sure to hit that subscribe button and then you'll be notified every single time I upload a brand new video, just like this one, to my YouTube channel. But that's all I have for you guys in this video. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll catch you all in the next one.